Come, Holy Spirit, come fill my heart, refresh my soul.
This is your season of grace with your host, Patrick Henry Edet. Get ready for Grace Revolution.
The word advance, according to the dictionary, has the following meaning. Advance has to do with go forward. Advance means progress. Advance is a word, is a verb word. There is advance as noun word. When you talk about advanced studies, that should be adjective. But we are dealing with advance as a verb word, action word. The first chapter of Deuteronomy, verse 6, the Lord our God said to us at Horeb, you have stayed long enough at this mountain. The next verse says, break camp and advance. All I just wanted you to know that this is a divine command. That's all I wanted to take from that scripture. I just want you to see that this is a divine command. It's not human. It's not some kind of ministry motivation. It is actually a mandate. So let's come to the place of a command. God says, break camp and advance into the hill country of the Amorites. God asks me to tell you, can one advance without a way? When God says, break camp and advance into, to advance into means there is a way. Am I talking to somebody? You cannot advance without the way, without direction. So advance is not a blind action. It's not a blind movement. That's not what advance means. Without the way, there is no advance. That's a fresh word from God. To advance means there is the way. Tell somebody the way. Let's go to the scripture. John chapter 14. Let's just read from verse 1 and enjoy the word of God. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. That also means the season of advance is a season of trust. If you don't trust, you cannot go. Am I talking to somebody? If you don't trust me, you cannot follow me. As a commander, one basic thing, the way the military is programmed to make the troop, every soldier trust is superior. Every soldier trust is commander. At any point that the troop, the soldier do not trust the commander, they are gone forever. Nobody can help them. So, the soldiers are wired to trust their commander. Whatever they are told, they say, shoot. They don't ask why they shoot. Except in rare cases, extraordinarily rare case, that a commander will say, shoot. And for that to happen, it means the commander has lost moral rights over the troops. In that case, the troop does not have moral obligation to obey. But in a normal situation, when a commander says move, you don't ask why, you just go. And so there has to be trust. There has to be a connection of trust between the one who says advance and the one who needs to advance. In this case, God is the ultimate commander. Praise God. Among the people of Israel, God made it clear to the people that God was the king of Israel. God was the commander of Israel's army. God was the judge. Every other one sat on behalf of God. The king was a judge on behalf of God. That's why the king had to judge injustice, because he represented God. The army commander had to trust God before he could command, because the army of Israel is called the army of God. Am I talking to somebody? So there has to be a relationship of trust between the commander, that is God, and the troop. All of us seated here, we are soldiers, or we are supposed to be soldiers in the Lord's army. How many of you will know it? Yeah, many people don't know it. Because you think being alive and being a Christian is your personal affair. It's a matter of That's not what being a Christian is about. Being a Christian is being part of God's agenda, being part of God's family, being part of God's inheritance, inheriting God, living for God, fighting for God on earth, for the dominion of God on earth. Once you are born again, you are part of God's agenda. You are pivotal in the arrangement of God. You are important. And God is your commander. So in your family, God can tell you, bring about reconciliation. If you don't bring about, you are in trouble with God. Am I talking to somebody? You can be newly born again, and the first agenda of God for you is that bring about reconciliation in your family. Or bring people together to pray. If you understand me, shout hallelujah. So the reason why many people cannot advance, because there is no trust relationship between them. They don't have a place in the army of God. They don't see themselves as God of part of God's agenda. A lot of people see God as their servant rather than they seeing themselves as God's servant. So a lot of people, when they come to a place like this, or they go to church, the interest is God should serve my purpose. No, it is God will give you. But that's not the main thing. The main thing is God's purpose. That wife is for what? That is the purpose. That husband is for what? That is the purpose. That business is for what? That is the purpose. That business ought to honor God. So you begin to see yourself as a soldier in the army of God. And then you have to have a trust relationship. You will not hear God or see God directly, but through the instrumentality of prophets, those who speak on behalf of God, there has to be trust. And how do you have trust? There must be relationship. Tell somebody, relationship. You see, your relationship with God is the foundation for the impossible. Write it down. Your relationship with God is the foundation for advance. Your relationship with God is the foundation for enduring miracle. Not just miracle. Enduring, lasting miracle. There are different grades of miracles. You can receive a miracle one night. After 3 nights, you lose it. Or you have problem in another area that discounts completely the benefit of the miracle in one area. But your relationship with God, which is about trust, you trust God, you obey Him. You don't obey somebody until there is a trust. You only obey the one you trust. Is it not true? If you don't trust a man, you don't obey him. So Jesus Christ said, do not let your hearts be troubled. Be confident. Trust in God. Praise God. Trust also in me. Colossians chapter 1 verse 15. The word of God says of Jesus, he is the image of the invisible God. the firstborn from all creation. Glory to God. The image of the invisible God. The image of God means the representative, the official representative of God. The one who represents God whole and entire. The one who is the perfect representative of God. He is the ambassador of God per excellence. He is the original and perfect ambassador of God. All of us in Christ, in Him, Christ, we become image of God. Representative of God. As I'm standing here, you may not like me, but I represent God. I am His image. Image at double fold level. Image as a child of God. Image as a representative of His government. Absolutely. I carry force. And I know it is true. I don't carry microphone by force. Force will not bring you to sit down here. There is a grace that draws you because God is telling you there's somebody who is representing me. So I am on official function, which is why I have authority to stop demons from operating and they don't operate. Why? Because I am acting in official capacity. Glory to God. To advance, there has to be a relationship of trust with God and a relationship of trust with the one who represents God at official level. You see, the scripture says, believe in God, you shall do what? You shall be established. Believe also in His prophet, you shall do what? Prosper, that means you will advance. Prosper means you will increase. You will advance. Glory to God. So, Jesus begins with trust. Do not let your heart trouble. I have the answer. Jesus is telling you, I have the answer. I know what you don't know. I can do what your father cannot do. I can do what your husband has no idea of. That pregnancy you carry forever, I don't have to do like this for it to end. I can end it without batting an eyelid. I just hold control over everything. When I am the captain of your ship, rest and sleep. Amidst the waves. Trust in God, but trust in me also. Everything that is greater than you is nothing before Him. As I'm talking, I am bringing things down in your life. Everything that has been exalted over you, everything that has weighed you down, is nothing compared to His power. I trample it underfoot now in the name of Jesus. Officially, I declare that what had weighed you down ceases to have power over you. Just as a trust in me also. Relationship. Whereas you are thinking healing, He's thinking trust. Whereas you are thinking breakthrough, He's thinking trust. Why? Because breakthrough is not a problem to Him. When He wanted to deliver Peter, an angel just appeared and the chains fell. Nobody touched the chain. The angel didn't touch the chain. He just woke Peter up. As Peter straightened up, the chains respected. Why? Because an official representative of Jehovah came in. You don't understand what I'm talking about. When God sends an official missionary, a representative of His kingdom, I don't need to come and lay hands on all of you for this to happen. As I'm speaking, as you rise, chains are falling in the name of Jesus. I said, chains are falling. Chains of sickness. Chains of bondages, chains of captivity, chains of stagnation, chains of barrenness, chains of delay, they are broken in the name of Jesus. The angel didn't talk about the chain because the chain was not important. He said, Peter, stand up, it is time to go. Advance. The angel told Peter, advance. And you cannot imagine, as Peter stood up, chains left. As if that was not enough. As they advanced towards the way, every door of his own accord honored them. Why? God was not there. An official representative of God was there. The angel came. La brozendeli katali brazondeli katalabra. You see, God has no problem with your chain, because before him darkness is not dark. Before him night is as bright as day. He lives in unapproachable light. Darkness has no issue with him, and he has no, because he is the creator of light and is the light of life. Glory to God. Praise God. So whatever is your obsession makes no sense to him. You may be thinking healing, is thinking trust. Trust me. Trust me, I can handle it. Trust me, I can deliver you. Trust me, the day I will set you free, that python will no longer hold you. He said, trust me. Shout hallelujah. He said, trust in me also. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, we're talking about many rooms, provision. Room means provision. There's accommodation for every situation. Verse 4, it tells them, you know the way to the, I'm going to, you know the way to the destination. I like Thomas. People say Thomas is a doubter. Don't be here doubting Thomas. There's no better person to be like in the scripture than Thomas. Thomas makes Jesus reveal some mysteries. Peter doesn't allow Jesus to reveal mystery, because Peter just jumps in, jumps out, and all that. But Thomas pins Jesus down. He said, the way you are talking, take it easy. Peter, before Peter will hear, he will jump. But Thomas said, wait. I need understanding. Tell somebody, wait. I love Thomas. Every time Thomas speaks, Jesus, he provokes Jesus to reveal something more. Thank God for Thomas. Thomas said to him, Lord, take it easy. We don't even know where you are going to. So how can we know the way? You're talking about the way as if everybody knows it. You know, some people, when you say, do you understand? They throw their head. But God knows they don't understand. Come on, if you don't understand, say, I don't understand. There are certain times I tell God, I don't understand. I don't understand why I pray. You don't show me certain things. I don't understand. I disagree with. Let me know it. Faith is not just saying, yes, yes, yes. Let me understand something. Let me know what to believe. Praise God. And look at what Jesus will say because of this Thomas. Jesus answered, I am the way. La telebrozoli catalianda. Mi librozondoli catalia mandelebroze. I am the way. Can you imagine? If Thomas had not pinned the master down, Jesus would not say, this is the only way, that the only place that Jesus says, I am the way. I don't know of another place. Please, if you find another place in the scripture, let me know. He says, I am the way. It means when you are talking about advance, I am the way of advance. If you must go in, you must come through me. And if you must come out of that thing, because when we talk about advance, advance means come out of trouble. Advance means enter peace. Whether you are coming out of trouble, you need the way. Whether you are entering into peace, you need the way. Without the way, there is no advance. So Jesus Christ is making a fundamental declaration. He's saying, I am the way. I am the way means I am the possibility of advance. Which means if you have me, get ready to advance. If you have me, anyone who has Jesus here, get ready to advance. Anyone who has Jesus says, get ready to advance. It is your season. It is your season. It is your season. It is your season. Absolutely. When you have Jesus, get ready to advance. You cannot have Jesus. There are certain prayers you shouldn't pray as a child of God, because you already have solution. When you know that you have the way, there are certain things you don't talk about. You enter into your rest. enter into your peace. You know, the Lord, Lord, give me peace. Lord, give me peace. Give me peace. Give me peace. Give me peace. He is the way, and you have him. Enter into peace. Tell demons, get out. I am in my peace. Glory to God. As I'm speaking, everything that you have been stuck with, now you know you have the way out. Stand up and lift up and say, I have the way out. So advance is possible. Advance is real. Move forward. From tonight, now that you know this truth, I can command you, move forward from sickness. Glory. Say, I am the way. I am the truth. I am the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The one who wants marriage is coming to the Father. The one who wants healing is coming to the Father. The one who wants deliverance is coming to the Father. Because every good and perfect gift comes from the Father, from above. Which means, if you are looking for this, you are looking for the Father. And he says you cannot get there. If you marry without the Father, you will die. Marriage can swallow you. So don't long for marriage. Long for God who will give you marriage. Because business without God can be a graveyard. Opportunity without God can be the greatest depression you will have in life. If you put God upon anything, it changes. Am I talking to somebody? And so just as they say, you are looking for peace, it's with the Father. But you know what? You don't get to the Father except through me. I am the way. I am the truth. Can I tell you something? If you have been trying to avoid giving your life to Jesus Christ, all you have been doing is you have been trying to avoid all the blessings in this world. You've been trying to avoid your destiny. You've been trying to avoid your deliverance. You've been trying to avoid your breakthrough. And you look for some prophet who will prophesy so that from a distance you receive the breakthrough of God. No, God doesn't give from a distance. God gives through the door. He says, I am the way. No one comes to the Father except through me. If the Father must heal you, it must be through me. If the Father must deliver you, it must be through me. If you must advance, it must be through me. You see, Jesus is the one. If you don't want him when you are going, you will want him when you are coming back. If you don't need him when you are rising, you will need him when you are falling. If you don't need him when you are born, you will need him when you are dying. You cannot do without him. The earlier, the better. Can somebody just close your eyes? I just want to give, if you know Jesus, I just want you to know how blessed you are. You have the greatest thing. Now you can never cry after this moment. You will go home today and show force, show confidence. Say, I have the way, by the way. I have the way out of this debt. I am prophesying over somebody that is owing and you are afraid of even living in your house. Can I tell you the truth? You have a way out of that debt. How you will pay it, I don't know. But if you have Jesus, I want to pronounce 21 days. A way will come out. Except your case is not desperate. It says Jesus will manifest in your life as the way in the name of Jesus.
This program is sponsored by the Covenant Friends and Partners of Grace Family Global Outreach. You can be part of this grace revolution by becoming a Covenant Partner today. Allow God to use you. Our account details are as follows. Bank, Zenith Bank. Account name, Grace Family Global Outreach. Account number, 101-42-978-63. For inquiries, please call 081-804-33225 or 090-738-38742. To all our Covenant partners and friends, we say thank you. Like the widow of Zarephath, your oil will never run dry. To order for the books, messages, and other resource materials, please call or send an SMS to 080-660-46346 or 081-804-33225. Videos are also available on YouTube at www.youtube.com/Grace Family Outreach. To stay connected, like us on Facebook at Grace Family Outreach or visit our website at www.gracecommission.org.